Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video on Scaffold as a part of the Jetpack Compose tutorial series, we have understood how to set up the top app bar and add action buttons to them. But here we will get started with adding a couple of more small features to the top app bar. The first thing that I want to talk about is adding the navigation button. What do I mean by the navigation button? On the extreme left hand side of the app top bar, you can actually add some icons. Let's assume that I had clicked on the very first card, which is South Africa country info card, and I had navigated to another screen. On that screen, to indicate that you can go back to the previous screen containing the South Africa card, I could have added this navigation icon to that particular screen. How to add that particular navigation icon is something that we will explore in this particular video. And not only that, you can actually add a particular behavior when the scrolling happens. That is, as you can see here, as I scroll the card, the country info app in the top app bar actually scrolls itself above and hides it. That's a behavior that you can add to the top app bar. We will explore how to implement that feature as well. Other than that, we will understand how to implement the bottom app bar and also adding a button which floats in the main content section of the screen, that is floating action button. We will see how to integrate that as well into our application. So without wasting much time, let's get into a demo. So this is the application. So just below the title, what I can do is I will add navigation icon, and under navigation icon, I can add something similar to icon button, but instead of search, I will use arrow back. Once again, I am using the icon which is available as a part of the icon collection of material theme. And if I just run this, you will start seeing the icon, that is navigation icon. Right now, this is the landing screen. Showing this particular icon here actually doesn't make sense. So let me just comment it out. Now, other than this, I was talking about adding the scroll behavior. That is, when I scroll this particular list view or lazy column, it should have an impact on this particular button and it should hide itself. Now, how do we do that? For that, first we will have to create a scroll behavior, that is val scroll behavior, and you can initialize this value with top app bar defaults dot enter always scroll behavior, and then pass remember top app bar state. This particular scroll behavior we can pass as an one of the argument after actions, that is scroll behavior. And not only that, to the scaffold along with the top bar you can pass the modifier, and to that particular modifier you can set nested scroll, scroll behavior dot nested scroll collection. If I do this and then rerun the application, you will see that when I scroll, this particular app bar actually hides itself. There are more options other than this. I suggest you go through the documentation and start exploring it, but this is the very basic idea of adding the scroll behavior to the scaffold top app bar. The next one that we want to learn is adding the bottom app bar. Once again, it is pretty simple. It has to come here, that is outside the top app bar. That is where you have to define bottom app bar, and inside the bottom app bar, let me move these two out of this and put it. So now if I rerun this, you will start seeing that it has a bottom app bar, but this is not showing correctly. The reason why it is not showing correctly is I will have to add the bottom app bar and paste these icon buttons under this bottom app bar. That was the mistake that I had done. So now let me run this. Yeah, exactly what we needed. So this is how you add the bottom app bar. And the only last remaining thing now is floating action button. So just pay attention how we do that. So once again, floating action button, and under this I will have to add icon, and once again image vector, I can say icons dot field dot filter, and then description filter. I think in the bottom app bar I am already using the filter, so let me just remove it. And now if I run this, you will start seeing that particular icon here on the bottom right corner. But this doesn't look good because it doesn't have the proper background and the elevation that it needs. Not a problem, we can achieve that. So what we can do is just cut this and put a floating action button, and then I can set container color. Once again, bottom app bar defaults dot bottom app color fab color, and then you can set the elevation as well. Floating action bar defaults dot bottom app bar fab elevation. And if you want to give any specific elevation values, you can pass it here. You can put the icon that you wanted to put under this lambda function. And we are basically done with this. And if I run this, you should be able to see the floating action button. And that's it. Right now, these things don't have any real function, but I am just talking about how to add these UI elements to a application. That's it. Right now, that is our intention. We will add more functionalities using these and build this app into something more useful in the upcoming videos. So that's it about the scaffold. Stay tuned for new concepts in Jetpack Compose in the upcoming future videos. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.